do we measure the height of a tree? Would you climb all the way up to the top of a tree? Even if you could, do you have a super long tape measure to actually measure it? Even if you have the super long tape measure, are you sure that you can measure straight so that your result will be accurate? Today, we're going to use some math skill to get an accurate height of a tree. Here is our neighborhood park. This park is our dog's favorite place to mark his territory and search through some trashed food or even some other dog's delicious poop. Oh, but I'm glad today is a sunny day because only on a sunny day you're able to use your favorite math. Why? Because we're going to use shadow to do some math. And I think I'll choose this big tall tree here. This is my friend Amy.
Hello.
And I'm going to measure her height and her shadow. Now, let's figure out some math. My friend Amy, her shadow, and the sun ray of Amy form a right triangle. Why is it a right triangle? Because Amy vertically stands on the ground. Same to the tree. The tree and tree's shadow and the sun ray off the tree form another right triangle. So what is the relationship between these two right triangles? The answer is they are similar. Why they are similar? According to triangle similarity theory, if two pairs of angles in these two triangles that are congruent, then these two triangles are similar. They already have a pair of right angle. Both of them are 90 degrees. That's a pair. They also have another pair of acute angle. They are congruent. Why? Because the Earth is moving around the Sun. The shadow length is changing while the Earth is moving around the Sun. So the angle the sun rays cast off subjects varies at different times. The time when we measured the tree's shadow and Amy's shadow were within about half an hour. So these two acute angles were about the same. Now, let's set up a proportion because these two triangles are similar. Let's set x as unknown height of the tree. From top to the bottom, let's see here. So we measured Amy's actual height is 5'7", and her shadow is 5'8". We're going to use Amy's actual height over her shadow length equal tree's actual height over tree's shadow length, which is 15 feet. Just because left side 5-7 and 5-8, they're very close. I'm going to assume I'm just round up the left side equals 1. So that means x is about 15 feet, which is equal to the shadow. So 15 over 15 is 1. This is one way. Or you can use the cross multiply. So convert 5-7 into inches and 15 into inches. They multiply together and equal to 5 feet and 8. I convert that into inches, multiply by the x, and then we can cross multiply, find out x. Worry, you can measure tree shadow anytime. You just have to use proportions and use cross multiply, find out the tree's height. But remember, convert all the different units between feet and inch into all inches. Now we can use this method to apply to measure the height of any tall vertical structures, such as a building, a light pole, a power line pole, a flag pole,